not friends.
So you know the water I put in the other day, it looked a bit green.
Well, this is it. It's all got like all this mank. It's got this mank all settled on the bottom of it.
It's like things growing in there.
Which of course means that's in my tank, so I'm gonna drop some out.
And just hope that it's just sitting on the bottom and
get that out of there.
Got this cleaner stuff actually to put in, which I've had sitting in here for like a year.
Today we'd cross the border out of Wales and head on down to Cornwall.
These roads, no joke, these are like steeper than the Alps here. Jesus Christ. I wondered why it was stinking of brakes at the bottom of this hill. All the cars coming down here must be the brakes on fire. Good girl, good girl.
2 minutes ago, we were down at like pretty much sea level, and look at this. There's some serious hill climbing. I was going like, fuck. Brakes are on the verge of stopping, as in like stopping working. I'm about to close the window on Sam because he keeps grabbing the bushes and. And like she's ended up just, look, she's just coughed them up here. Sitting there coughing up loads of branches. It doesn't matter how fast we're going, if that branch is close enough to the van, she's gonna grab it. Nuts, man!
So I'm very much a free camper, wild camper, whatever. I don't have to pay for where I park up for the night. And getting to Cornwall, I realised that this is actually quite a difficult thing to do there. But we found this place that's £2 for a night, so can't really argue with that. The place had some awesome views and the beach was just a 10-minute walk down the cliffy path. We met up with my buddy Russ and his little dog Samuel, who you might remember from my winter van life vlogs out in the Alps this winter. Sam showed Sam just how much he'd missed her and Sif provided the sunset entertainment.
There's a beautiful little cove down just from where we're staying here, so we're gonna go and take the swim. Maybe a little wash. Maybe I'm a bird following the seasons. This is what I've learned. I'm different for a reason. You're getting it, Sam, you're getting it. Get the engine on.
There you go.
Because the water's so clear, I can see that she wasn't using a back leg.
You got it, you buena chica. Here you are.
There you go. Yes, sir. Love me like a stranger. There's not many waves been in Newquay recently. However, they're here today. And I've gone and bought a little second-hand surfboard. My mate Jackie has come down to teach me how to surf. It's gonna be fun. Board. I had to get a bit of a shorter board than I should have really for learning on, but just so I can fit it in the back of the van. And my teacher.
Okay, so I ended up taking a break from filming from maybe like a week or two. Most of this time I spent chilling out with friends and finishing the final part of my latest ebook. And then I found myself here, which is Cape Cornwall, the absolute tip of the UK. And as you can see, it's a pretty nice place.
You know when you get the morning right,
Well, apart from just gargling mouthwash into my eye on dropping the kitchen roll into the wet sink, I've just done that. This morning's been right. You see, I've had this morning routine that I've done since like the 1st of January this year. I did it every day up until like the end of April. I started getting a bit sloppy with it and it just took a turn for the worse. But I'm getting back on it. And you know, it makes such a difference to just the way I feel every day. So basically this morning, yeah, routine fully done. Been for a run as well, which is like, it's not a normal routine thing. That's like an extra, you know, so been for a run. Morning.
Morning.
Yeah, I'm just telling everyone how good my morning was.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Where did you shower?
Well, you see, where did I shower? Just had a little shower here. Oh yeah. It's a pretty nice shower spot, you know? The last part of this vlog was, I think, Jackie taking me surfing, which is like, what? That's over a week ago, is it? Is that 2 weeks? No.
No, it can't be. Week and a half.
So that was the last time I vlogged, right? And since then, basically, I've been doing this ebook. This ebook has taken so much of my time. But today, ebook is done. I'm sure I'll put a link below in this video for that. And the surf is looking good. Maybe a little too good for me, actually. Do you think it's a little bit too big?
You're on a shorty, so maybe it'll be more fun for you.
Or impossible. Do you think, how big are they? Have you looked this morning?
No, I looked last night.
How big?
It'll be washed out, so it'll be like 4 to 5 foot, but I think it's going to be really, once you take off, you'll be like all over the place.
Okay, 4 to 5 foot sounds all right. So, today we're moving on, getting surfing, and by Friday, it's now Tuesday, by Friday I want to be in France.
So we went to two different beaches where both the car parks were absolutely jam-packed, so we couldn't even park there. So eventually I found one beach. But the waves are pretty big.
Some serious waves out there. Definitely too big there. So, next beach. Heaven is a half pipe and Jesus was a surfer.
Look, no surfboards on this one.
Bit of a disappointment.
So we found some waves here about sort of size that aren't gonna be too scary and kill me, but good enough to learn on, so. A little bit. Take a mattress in the back of a car. Drive down south, stop off whenever we want. Pick a lay by, pick a fun, and we'll lose ourselves, feel the salty water kissing your toes, let the freckles sweet appear on your nose. Where we wanted to be. I can bring the coffee cups and you can bring the coffee. Pick me up at 5 o'clock, you got me where you want me. Waves just break a little better when I'm with you. When the sun reappears, we wake up slow. No need to check the weather, cause I already know. Waves just break a little better when I'm with you.
That's the most one I've had in ages. Caught a couple of waves, nothing major like, but well enjoyed it. Smile on my face for 24 hours now. I think I'm gonna spend the night here, because, well, there's a bar there, and a beach there. What else do you need? Oh, toilets.
Right, so what's happened here is I'm on my way to Plymouth and I kind of went a little bit of the wrong way and now I'm getting a ferry. But I think it's only a cheap little ferry. I thought it was going to be like a mega expensive ferry, like, you know. But apparently it's just £1.50. So, where do I go? Whoa, it's tiny! Is this the one to France?
Yeah.
I thought I got the wrong one.
Spain if you want.
Spain would be better, to be honest. Cheers, man, thanks. I think it must be like on a chain, this ferry, because it's like... It's a good job I'm not more hungover, because I'd be puking. Chica malaria.
What? You like ferry?
Oh, it's a seagull. You want to bite it? Bite it?
What's he doing, a seagull?
He's looking at you, son. Oh, look, he's showing his strength. He's like biting the wire. Yeah, happy with this spot. It's pretty sweet. You like it? There's loads of dogs playing over there, aren't there? You want to go out? Oh. Oh, look, a navy ship, which I've got something to tell you about in a minute, actually. But first, let's take you out. Bally, bally, go. Oh, don't kill that ball, son. Yeah. Morning, guys. I realised the last thing I said to you was about, I'll tell you about the ship in a minute, but then things happened and it got to morning, so good morning. And the ship, a internet friend of mine.
Oh, friend! Friend!
Ross has invited me, very kindly invited me, for a private tour of his ship. His ship being the Albion. Which, let me tell you, I'm pretty excited to see. So I'm just heading to meet Ross now. Ross, in fact, I'm not gonna tell you about Ross, I'll let Ross tell you about Ross. All right, guys, thanks for watching. I hope you liked it. If you did, give us a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already, and ding my bell, because you won't even know if I've uploaded a video otherwise. Cheers, guys, see you on the next one. Sen, are you two in?
Easy, okay. Easy.